फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल एसएम लेक्चर सीरीज। योर ओनली स्टॉप टू गेट ऑल द नॉलेज ऑफ फाइनाइट एलिमेंट एनालिसिस, कैडकैम, सीएई एंड मेनी अदर सब्जेक्ट्स। ऑल्सो योर वन स्टॉप डेस्टिनेशन टू लर्न सॉफ्टवेयर्स लाइक सॉलिड वर्क्स, मास्टर कैम, ऑटोडेस्क फ्यूजन 360 एंड मेनी मोर टू कम। प्लीज डू लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टू स्टे अपडेटेड विद द लेटेस्ट नॉलेज। थैंक यू। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द शेप फंक्शंस एंड इंटरपोलेशन फंक्शंस फॉर क्वाड्रेटिक बार एलिमेंट। सो वी विल सी द शेप फंक्शंस and interpolation functions in all the three coordinates, that is global coordinates, local coordinates and natural coordinates. So to begin with, I have drawn here a quadratic bar element. Now quadratic bar element has three nodes. Okay, it is a bar element, so it is one dimensional element but with three nodes. Okay, so this is the global reference, okay, and all the dimensions, okay, or the distances from the global references are respectively for node 1 is x1, for node 2 is x2, and for node 3 is x3. So x is the variable, okay, which represents the length, okay, in the horizontal direction. So if we are concerned about the boundary conditions, okay, the x value at node number 1 is x1, okay, x's value at node number 2 is x2, and respectively x value at node number 3 is x3. Okay, now we will be using here the direct method, which is the property of shape function method. So we will form equations, okay, we will form equations, and then we will develop a relation wherein shape function is proportional to multiplication of all these three equations, and then at a particular node we will omit that equation from the required set of equations and find out the shape function at that particular node. So that is going to be the approach. So x equal to x1, x equal to x2, x equal to x3. Now when I bring everything on one side, so I get x minus x1 equal to 0, x minus x2 equal to 0, x minus x3 equal to 0. So at I can say that the shape function, okay, the shape function, which is n, is proportional to, okay, x minus x1, also it is proportional to x minus x2, and also it is proportional to x minus x3. So I can say shape function is equal to some shape factor multiplied by these three equations, okay, at respective nodes. Now at node 1, okay, now what I will be doing, okay, let me write it here. At node 1, we know that n is equal to n1 is equal to 1. So at node 1, if we are trying to find out the property of shape function, okay, so it says that the summation of shape function over the entire element should be equal to 1. Okay, so at any particular node location, the value of that particular shape function will be maximum 1, and at the same time it will be 0 at all other nodes. So n equal to n1 equal to 1, and I know that value of x at node 1 is x1. Okay, so what I will be doing, I will be deleting the first term, that is x minus x1, okay, and I will be rewriting the equation in terms of n1 as shape factor. Okay, I have deleted this term, so this term will not be present. Okay, this term will not be present, so I will only have x minus x2 and x minus x3. Now I will use these boundary conditions. So I know that n1 is 1, shape factor, and x is what? x1. So x1 minus x2 and x1 minus x3. So that gives me the value of shape factor as 1 upon this whole thing, that is x1 minus x2 and x1 minus x3. And when I put this back into the equation, that is n1, so what I get? shape factor is this. So I get x minus x2 multiplied by x minus x3 divided by x1 minus x2 multiplied by x1 minus x3. So this is what the shape function n1 I get at node number 1. Okay, so if you closely observe, okay, we have the variable x, okay, present in the numerator. So x minus x2 multiplied by x minus x3. Now x1, x2, x3 are what? These are distances, okay, these are distances from the reference, global reference, but x is a variable. So if you find out the order of this equation, the order is 2. So x square term is present in the numerator, okay, x square term is present in the numerator. So n1, that is shape function, is of the order 2 polynomial, okay, it is order 2 polynomial, and it completely coincides with the order of the element. So order of the element is what? It is a quadratic behavior, okay, quadratic bar element. So its order is also 2, and the same order shape function has also got, okay. So that just proves it again, okay. Similarly, we will do this for the node 2 location. So what happens at node 2? Okay, I know that n equal to n2 equal to 1 and x becomes x2. So what I will be doing, I will be deleting the second term for finding n2. So now I will be deleting this term. So I will not include this term. So eventually I will have n2 equal to shape factor, okay, multiplied by the first term, that is x minus x1, multiplied by the last term, x minus x3. Okay, so now I will include the boundary condition. So n2 value is 1 is equal to shape factor. Now I know that at x equal to x2, or at node 2, x is equal to x2. So it will become x2 minus x1, x2 minus x3. So in other words, my shape factor becomes 1 upon x2 minus x1, x2 minus x3, and that gives me the value of n2. When I put this shape factor back into this equation, the value of n2 becomes what it is, x minus x1 multiplied by x minus x3 divided by x2 minus x1 multiplied by x2 minus x3. So this is the shape function at node number 2, that is n2. And if you closely observe, this is also order 2 function, polynomial, order 2 polynomial. So it is also quadratic in nature. So in the numerator you have x square term present, okay, and in the denominator these are all distances, okay, same with the case of n1. So now we are only left with the third condition, that is at node 3. Okay, so what happens at node 3? Node 3, I know that n equal to n3 equal to 1 and x is equal to x3. So what happens is, I will replace the above function, okay, by n3, and I will delete, yeah, I forgot to write that, okay, of course I will be deleting the equation at node 3, that is x minus x3. Why we have to delete? Otherwise this will give us 0, okay, so we'll not have any equation to solve. That is why we have to omit. So deleting means we are not considering that equation. So in trying to find out the shape function at that particular node, so that equation we are omitting. Okay, so I have n3 is equal to shape factor multiplied by x minus x1, x minus x2. Okay, now if I use the boundary condition, so I know that n3 is 1 is equal to shape factor. Now value of x at node number 3 is x3, so it will happen as x3 minus x1 and x3 minus x2. Okay, I am referring to these conditions. So this gives me shape factor as वन अपॉन x3 minus x2 and that in turn gives me n3 is equal to, okay, I have shape factor multiplied by this x minus x2 divided by x3 minus x2. So this is the value of n3, that is shape function at node number 3. So as you can see, all these shape functions are following a typical sequence. Okay, all these shape functions are following a typical sequence. So if we want to capture that typical sequence, okay, then okay, I will write a general shape function finding, okay, general rule to find shape function, okay, in global coordinates. So it goes like this: n, okay, n of I over j, okay, n of I over j is given by x minus xj upon xi minus xj. So now, keeping this particular function in mind, okay, randomly if I ask you to find, let's say, n of 2, so, or let us start with n of 1, okay, so I is going to be 1, okay, and what are the remaining values of j? So remaining values of j are 2 and 3, okay, so how I am going to write this? I am going to write this as x minus first value of j, that is x2, okay, then x minus second value of j, that is x3, divided by, okay, first value of I, it is going to be always first value of I, second value of j, okay, first value of I, second rather first value of I, first value of j, first value of I, second value of j, okay, so that is how we can directly write the this is going to be the n1. Now similarly, I can write, let's say, n3 over, let's say, 1 and 2. Okay, so how I can write? X minus x1, okay, x minus x2 divided by x3 minus x1, x3 minus x2. Okay, so I hope you get what I am trying to say. So this is a shape function finding method, okay, when we will be dealing with two-dimensional elements, okay, at that time we have to deal with two different kinds of element families or shape function families. So this particular method is a shape function family called as Lagrangian family of shape functions, okay, Lagrangian family of shape functions. So we will see that in details, okay, in the two-dimensional elements, when we deal with two-dimensional elements. Okay, now what we will do is, okay, we have already seen the shape functions for the global coordinates. Okay, now we will see shape functions for local coordinates for this quadratic bar element. And of course, okay, we forgot to write over here the interpolation functions. Okay, so let us first finish the interpolation function. So interpolation functions remains to be the same. So u is equal to n1 u1 plus n2 u2 plus n3 u3. So this is going to be my interpolation function. Why we are going till n3 u3? Simple reason, we have three nodes. Okay, simple reason, we have three nodes. Okay, that is the reason why we have found three shape functions. So my interpolation function will also involve the shape function multiplied by primary variable and so on. So it is summation ni xi, okay, or summation ni ui, okay, summation ni ui. So it is going to be n1 u1 plus n2 u2 plus n3 u3. Okay, so this is my interpolation function. Now we will see the shape function for local coordinates. Okay, shape function for local coordinates. So it is given in this manner. now in local coordinates I know that the origin is the left node. Okay, so this is x equal to 0. Okay, I will always try to orient these nodes at equal distances. Okay, because that is going to be the ideal condition. I know that the total span is going to be L. So I will have second node at exactly half distance. So x equal to L by 2. Okay, I will just have to form the equation. So this will be just x. This is going to be x minus L by 2 equal to 0. This is the same thing, x equal to 0, and this is going to be x by L equal x minus L equal to 0. Okay, now again following the same shape function property, my shape function is going to be proportional to all these equations. So x multiplied by x minus L by 2 multiplied by x minus L. So eventually my shape function is equal to shape factor multiplied by these three equations. Okay, now if I have to individually find the shape functions at node number 1, node number 2, node number 3, this is node number 1, node number 2, node number 3. Remember we are dealing with quadratic bar element, so we will be again writing the similar condition. So at node 1 I have n equal to n1 equal to 1 and value of x is 0. Value of x is 0, so I will be deleting the x from this equation. So I will have n1 is equal to shape factor, we are not going to consider first equation, that is x minus l by 2 x minus l. So now I can use the boundary condition. So n1 is 1, shape factor I have to find, it will be 0 minus l by 2, 0 minus l. Okay, so when I do the multiplication, I find that shape factor becomes, shape factor becomes 2 by l square, 2 by l square, and my n1 becomes 2 by l square multiplied by x minus l by 2 multiplied by x minus l. So if you carefully observe this equation, this is my shape function at node number 1, that is n1. This is also a quadratic equation, this is an order 2 polynomial equation, x square term is present. X square term is present, everything else is nothing but the domain constants. So length of the element and 2 is a constant. So the equation involves x square term and it readily follows the behavior of the quadratic bar element, which is quadratic. So power 2. Now same thing we will do for the node 2. So let's say at node 2 n equal to n2 equal to 1 and x is now l by 2. So now I will be deleting the second term, that is x minus l by 2, and I will be rewriting this for n2. So n2 is equal to shape factor multiplied by x. I will delete the second term and the remaining term, that is x minus l. Now I will use these conditions, boundary conditions or end conditions, to find out the shape factor. So I know that at node 2 x value is l by 2. So this will be l by 2 multiplied by l by 2 minus l. L by 2 minus L. Now I know that L by 2 minus L is going to give me minus L. Minus L. That is minus L by 2. So minus L by 2 multiplied by L by 2. So it is going to give me minus L square by 4. So eventually my shape factor will be, eventually my shape factor is going to be the inverse of that. That is minus 4 by L square. And that is the reason why my N2 is going to become minus 4 by l square multiplied by x minus l. Now if you carefully observe this, this is also a order 2 equation or quadratic equation, and this readily follows the element behavior, which is also quadratic in nature. Now we will see at node 3. At node 3 I know that n equal to n3 equal to 1 and x equal to l. So now we are going to delete or omit basically the last term. Okay, if we don't omit the last term, this equation will not give me anything. This will always give me 0. Okay, so in order to find the value of the shape function at that particular node, keeping in mind the shape function property, okay, we are omitting this term. So that gives us n3 is equal to shape factor multiplied by x multiplied by x minus l. Okay, so that eventually if I apply these end conditions, okay, that gives me 1 equal to shape factor multiplied by, now at node number 3 x value is l, so it is l multiplied by, sorry, this is not l, this should be l by 2. Okay, so l minus l by 2. So what I will get, l by 2 multiplied by l, so again it is going to be l square by 2. So my shape factor eventually will become, what it will become, again 2 by l square. Okay, and if I find n3, okay, by putting shape factor here, I will get 2 by l square x multiplied by x minus l by 2. So as you can observe closely, even my n3 is a quadratic shape function, okay, which follows the behavior of the element itself, which is also quadratic in nature. So all these shape functions, as you can see, are quadratic even in my local coordinates. Okay, even in my local coordinates. Okay, in local coordinates as well, my interpolation function remains the same. Okay, if I have to represent local coordinate in this way, I can still represent n1 u1, n2 u2, n3 u3. This is going to be my interpolation function. So I hope you are following. Local coordinate system we had selected, and we had gone ahead and found out the all three shape functions at every node using the property of shape function method. Okay, using the property of shape function method. Okay, now we will go into the third coordinate system, that is natural coordinate system. Okay, we know that in natural coordinates the origin is at the center of the element. So now I have this three noded quadratic bar element. So I know that this is going to be the origin, that is zeta equal to 0. Okay, so this is node number 1, 2, 3. Here the variable zeta equal to minus 1, here variable zeta equal to 1, and at the center zeta should be equal to 0. Okay, zeta should be equal to 0. So if I again have to represent them in a set of equations, what I will do, I will bring everything on one side. So zeta plus 1 equal to 0, zeta equal to 0, zeta minus 1 equal to 0. Now I know that my shape function will be given by shape factor multiplied by all these equations. So zeta plus 1, zeta, zeta minus 1. Okay, now at each node, okay, I will have to delete that respective equation, okay, of that node, and find out the shape function. So at node 1, I know that n equal to n1 equal to 1 and zeta equal to minus 1, no, plus 1, zeta equal to minus 1. So what we will do here, we will delete the first term, zeta plus 1, okay, and rewrite the equation in terms of n1 as n1 equal to shape factor multiplied by zeta multiplied by zeta minus 1. So we will use these end conditions. So n1 value is 1 multiplied by, is equal to shape factor multiplied by, now zeta value at node number 1 is minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Okay, so what I have here, shape factor, okay, shape factor eventually becomes, this will give me minus 2 multiplied by minus 1. Okay, minus 2 multiplied by minus 1. So it is plus 2. So my shape factor is going to be 1 by 2. My shape factor is going to be 1 by 2. And that will eventually give me my shape function at node number 1, that is n1 as, okay, 1 by 2, or I will write zeta by 2 multiplied by zeta minus 1. So if you closely observe, zeta is the coordinate variable over here, okay, only being the only dimension, that is one dimensional element. So zeta we are measuring in terms of the horizontal x direction for natural coordinates. So zeta square is the term that I get in the numerator. So this n1 is a quadratic polynomial, okay, same as that of the nature of the element. So this is the shape function n1 in terms of natural coordinates for quadratic bar element. Same we will apply for the node number 2. So I know that n equal to n2 equal to 1. And at node 2, value of zeta is 0. So we will be deleting the second equation, that is zeta. Okay. So we will rewrite it as n2. Okay. Is equal to shape factor. We will not include the zeta term. So we will only have zeta plus 1, zeta minus 1. And we will use these end conditions. So n2 is equal to 1 in order to find this shape factor. To shape factor 0 plus 1 0 minus 1. So eventually this will give me zeta value as minus 1, or rather shape factor value as minus 1. Okay, this is plus 1 multiplied by minus 1 will be minus 1. Okay, will be minus 1. So minus 1 will go on this side. So 1 divided by minus 1 again minus 1. So my n2 will become okay minus of minus 1 into zeta plus 1 zeta minus 1, okay, zeta plus 1 zeta minus 1. So if I take this sign inside, okay, if I take this sign inside, what I will have is, okay, I can easily rewrite this as okay, 1 minus zeta, 1 plus zeta. Okay, in any case, the order of n2 is of power 2 because it is a zeta square equation. Okay, zeta square equation in the numerator, or it is only having a numerator. So this is the n2. Okay, this is the n2 that we get. Same if we apply for node number 3. So at node 3. We have n equal to n3 equal to 1, and value of zeta is 1 at node 3. So we are going to delete the last term, that is zeta minus 1. If we don't delete this term, okay, this equation will not hold good. It will always give us 0. So occasionally, okay, or alternatively, not occasionally, alternatively, we have to keep on deleting the equation at that particular node in terms of zeta. Okay, to get the value of shape factor and eventually to find out the value of shape function, okay, at that particular node. So this equation will be replaced by n3 equal to shape factor multiplied by zeta plus 1 multiplied by zeta. Now I will use this limiting condition. So 1 equal to shape factor, I have to find shape factor. So zeta value is plus 1 at node number 3. So this will give me shape factor of how much? This is 2 into 1. So this will give me shape factor of 1 by 2 again. Okay. And eventually my shape function n3 will become it is 1 by 2 multiplied by zeta plus 1. Okay. So this is going to be my n3. Okay, this is going to be my n3. Okay, here instead of writing in this way, okay, if you have to change it in this particular manner, okay, it's always better to write this zeta minus term ahead. Okay, so I just quickly change this sign, zeta minus 1, zeta plus 1. Okay, then convincingly you can change the sign. So if you take this minus 1 inside, what will happen? This zeta will have minus sign and this 1 will have plus sign. So how we are writing by keeping constant terms at the beginning. So 1 minus zeta will be this term, and then this is zeta plus 1, which we have rewritten as 1 plus zeta. Okay, I hope you are understanding. Okay, so as you can see, n1, n2, n3 both are all three shape functions are quadratic in nature, which coincides with the nature of the element, which is also quadratic, and consequently the interpolation function remains to be the same. Okay, now the one last thing is remaining is distribution of shape functions. Okay, distribution of shape function. So we will quickly do that. Okay, so the n1. Okay, n1 value is 1 at node number 1 and 0 at all other nodes. So this is the distribution of n1. This is 1 at node number 1 and 0 at all other nodes respectively. Similarly, I have distribution for n2, which gives me value 1 at node number 2 and 0 at remaining nodes. So this is my distribution n2. Again, I have this quadratic element with node numbers 1, 2, 3, and then the n3 distribution, that is distribution of shape function n3 over the element, is exactly opposite to that of n1. Remember, these are quadratic curves. Okay, so this is not a straight line anymore, it is a quadratic curve. This value is 1, okay, and these are my node numbers 1, 2, and 3. Okay, and if I have to find out the distribution of the interpolation function over the element, then that is also quadratic in nature. So let's say okay, so this is the distribution, the interpolation function u. This is u1, this is u2, this is u3, this is 1, 2. See, this particular distribution, this is not a straight line, this is a quadratic curve. Okay, so I am not saying this will be always like this. You can have u1 more, u2 less, u3 more. Okay, it can be anything, but the nature is going to be quadratic. Okay, if you cannot, let's say you have 3 points, okay, and I am asking you to join them by single curve, okay, then it has to be a quadratic curve. Okay, you cannot join these 3 points by two segments of lines like this. So when that is the condition, then I will have to pass a smooth curve whose order is 2. It's an order 2 curve, so it's a quadratic curve. So that is what we are seeing over here. So this is the distribution of shape function and interpolation function on the quadratic bar element. Okay, so I hope you have understood this. This was a very simple topic of discussion, where we have seen the shape functions and interpolation functions for quadratic bar element in all the three coordinate systems, and also we saw their distributions in the quadratic bar element. So I hope you have understood. If you like this video, please hit the like button, and if you feel that you want to see more such interesting content, then please subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon. Okay, I'll see you next time with more such interesting content. Thank you.